Yeah, hello. Once again, I'm here to talk about catfish farming. One of the basic reasons why I do most of my, lectures and I give pass out informations is because of the, terrible failure that is in the industry, the business of catfish farming. The truth is that catfish farming is profitable, but there's a lot of failure in it. You see people investing a lot of money, and then they don't come out with anything. They get very frustrated at the end of the day, and then they close up. So I try as much as possible to bring informations that will aid would-be farmers and those who are involved already on things to do so that they can have some profit in catfish farming. Now, one of the things I always talk about is mentorship. And of course, to gather the proper information, an internship in catfish farming. Many people just believe that catfish farming is about getting tanks and then putting water in it and throwing fish in it and then throwing feed into the ponds, into the tanks. No, that's not what it is. Like every other business of life, you must know about what you want to do. And the only way you can get to know about what you want to do in catfish farming, or like in any other business, is to be able to intend to learn. Learn what it is, or have a mentor who will direct you and guide you all through. Today, I am in the premises or house of one of my mentor, one of my students who intern under me, and also has chosen me as a mentor. I have a lot of them, but this one is about the most successful. He's a non-academic staff of the University of Port Harcourt. We are in the school premises, University of Port Harcourt. It's a beautiful place, and he's using his backyard. This is his house. I think this is his house, and this is his backyard. So it's a little place space he's using, but he has maximized the space a lot. And then this is him. His name is Peter Edoziem. So Peter, you like to say a few things to the people?
Yes, sir. I would like to say a few things because I'm so happy to have interned under you. When I mooted the idea of going into catfish rearing, I wasn't sure if I was going to be able to do it, but Providence brought me to you, our paths crossed, and I saw how serious you were in doing that, and I said, well, if somebody like you can be this serious, then what am I doing? And so I applied for internship, which you granted, and I followed through. The only aspect where I wasn't involved at that time was stocking. You have already stocked before I came in. But the feeding of the fish, the cleaning of the tanks, and up to the point of harvest, I followed through, and I saw a sorting. There was also sorting of the fish. So I saw all these, and to me, I was already prepared by you to start a business, and I was so eager. I had to even go and look for money from here and there to start the business. I started with 1,000 fish, post fingerless, and by the grace of God, while I started, so you continue to mentor me from start to the finish until we did our harvest. And by God's grace, we got our capital and we also got some profit on top. So that motivated me. I said, wow, if I could do this with 1,000, then if I have more, I can do more. So
Can you tell, sorry to cut you, can you tell the people how much you used for to rear 1,000 pieces of
Yes.
Post fingerlings to harvest level?
At the point where I started was when the COVID and demonstrations made feed prices skyrocket. So in all, from start to finish, I spent about 333,750 naira on feeding. And
Now, the reason why he spent 3,000, 333,000 on feeding was that you told me you stretched foreign feed.
Yes, I stretched foreign feed because I wanted rapid growth. And then at the time I was supposed to be feeding once a day, I was still doing twice a day. So that made my feed amount rise high.
Yeah, but the rapid growth and the rapid growth you wanted, quick result. I didn't teach you that. You learned it somewhere else.
You didn't teach me that because
you learned it from somewhere else.
I just
now, because this is the reason why we should maintain one mentor, listen to one person. Okay, go on, please.
Okay, somebody said that foreign feeds give faster growth, and so I deviated. But when I mentioned what I was doing to you and you advised that I should desist, I quickly desisted, and the result was fantastic.
Yeah, with local feed. Remember what we are saying. The reason why 1,000 post fingerlings to harvest stage came up to 330,000, it was because it stretched foreign feed. So you start with foreign feed, and then maybe 3 weeks or so, when they can pick 2 mm, you go immediately to local feed. And when they are 3 months, you just give one, you feed once. He was still feeding twice. Like, it is not necessary, because the difference when you feed twice and when you feed once properly in the morning is not much at all. Okay, so when you feed twice, you waste money. So at the end of the day, you made some profit, isn't it?
I did, sir, because having spent 333, I got 400 and something thousand. And in fact, with that, I quickly had to restock. Now I'm doing 2,500 pieces.
Wow. You see, because of the success he had, instead of, closing down the business, he has increased.
Yes.
Now, these are the tanks Peter is using, just a few tanks. This is one. This is two. This is three, and this is four. Peter, please come. Let's go on. Now, because Peter has had success in his first harvest, Peter has this zinc was not there before. This is his backyard, so he has now put zinc around his backyard. Guess what? He wants to increase the business.
I want to put like 10 or 15 tanks here.
Wow.
In addition to the four I have. And by God's grace, with 10 or 15 tanks, I can, in my next stocking, I can stock between 5,000 to 7,000. And you know what that means.
Wow.
I'll be making a lot of
But that means that you are going to be staying close to me.
Sure, sir. I'll never leave you.
Stay close to your mentor. Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Stay close to the people who are guiding you. And always choose your mentors by the success they're having in their own farms. Okay? Somebody came to me and told me that, look, somebody told him this is our catfish. I said, I've told you something. He said, but this person said this. I said, does the person have farm? He said, the person used to have, that his farm has closed. I said, but my farm is still on. You are listening to somebody whose farm has closed. Okay, so stay close to somebody who can guide you properly, and then listen to people who are succeeding in the business. Now, we are saying this because I want to address one of the issues here that is making people fail in the business. Catfish farming is profitable. It is lucrative. At least it won't give you the whole world, but it will at least put some money, pay some bills and all that.
Exactly.
But you must have to know what to do, or else you will fail.
Guided,
you know. Any last word, Peter?
Yes, sir. My last word is to thank you so much for being a wonderful mentor.
Oh, thank you.
Sir, you started with me from when I stopped, and you were present the day I did my harvest, supervised the harvest, and I couldn't have asked for more. Thank you so much, sir. And I wish that all those you will mentor after me will also follow your advice, do the things you said they should do. And I can assure them, success is theirs. Thank you so much, sir.
You're welcome, Peter. Thank you so much also for trusting in me and then following my informations and guidelines. Again, you know why we are doing this video. This particular video is to tell will-be farmers and those who are involved already that fish farming is not bad. It's not something you go into and you lose. The only reason why people lose is because they don't listen. They don't do what is supposed to be done. And one of the things among so many that's supposed to be done is for you to intern, is for you to learn, is for you to have a mentor that is successful in the business and listen to him or her. So many times people listen to too many farmers. Listen to one person who is succeeding and then you will succeed. Thank you. My name is Greg. And for you to keep having these clips coming to you all the time, subscribe to my YouTube channel. Immediately something like this drops, you'll be the first to get it. Thank you.